Hello, I'm Dr. Rahina Akhtar from Faculty of Dentistry at the University of Sydney. We have recently published a paper titled Risk Factors for Dental Caries Among Children with Cerebral Palsy in a Low Resource Setting. This paper is published in December 2016. Other co-authors for this paper are Dr. Hassan from Charles Sturt University, Professor Martin from University of Sydney, Professor Muhit and Dr. Hawk from University of South Asia, Dr. Smithy, Professor Jones and Professor Badi, and Dr. Khandokar from Children's Hospital at Westmead, Australia. The aim of our paper was to find out the world health status and factors affecting dental caries experience in a group of children with cerebral palsy in a low resource setting. As you all know, cerebral palsy is a physical disability that affects movement and posture. The neuromuscular problems inherent in CP can affect oral health and dental caries experience in significantly several ways. This can include changes in structure in the orofacial region, feeding problems, as well as difficulties in oral hygiene. Therefore, our aim was to find out these oral health status of this group of children who is suffering from cerebral palsy. For this study, we randomly selected 90 children with cerebral palsy aged 18 years and under. Caries experience was measured by identifying DMFT index, which means decayed, missing, or failed teeth index. We have also collected other data regarding BMI, oral hygiene, masticatory ability, as well as dietary habits. The neurological classification of cerebral palsy kids assessed by a pediatrician, which included spastic, dyskinetic, and ataxic movement. The severity of the functional mobility was assessed by gross motor function classification system, and this included mono or hemiplegic, diplegic, triplegic or quadriplegic. That means children who couldn't move their hands, one hand, two hands or two legs. According to our results, we found that 90 children with CP, their mean values for DMFT was 2.46 for the deciduous teeth, that means baby teeth, and 0.72 mean value for the permanent teeth, which is higher than a healthy subgroup, same group of children who are healthy. After adjusting age and gender, we found that a significant relationship with dental caries for children who is suffering from quadriplegia, that means who couldn't move their hand or legs. Children who only clean once per day or even none, they are much more vulnerable to develop dental caries than children who used to brush, or the carer used to brush twice per day. It is also found that children who use tooth powder or other vehicles for toothbrushing rather than using toothpaste, they are 7 times more vulnerable to develop dental caries experience than other kids who used toothpaste only. In terms of the dietary habit, we found that children who used to snack meals between the meals, they are much more vulnerable to develop dental caries experience than those who didn't. So from this study, we found that children in this population with more severe functional motor impairment might have a higher risk of developing dental caries, and which could be attributed due to inadequate oral hygiene. Therefore, efforts needs to be made to improve training to and organization of preventive dental care, as well as selecting an appropriate diet, modifying oral hygiene behavior, and promoting dental health of this challenged population. The next part of this study we are doing, we are now doing to see the World Health Relative Quality of Life of these children and the experience of dental care is so that you can find out the impact of the their daily life in these children.